Good morning, everyone. Hope you're all doing well. So we're on day 5 at the moment, and today I'm heading out on a walk for a few hours, and I'm just gonna show you what we see. I'm filming everything off of my little cell phone, so it has been challenging. It is challenging to try and show you guys what I can see. That the cell phone is just not really the best equipped wildlife filmmaking camera, but we're making do with what we can. So yeah, we're gonna head out on a walk for a few hours. It's an amazing time to get in touch with nature, to use your senses, to listen to stuff, hear what the bush is telling you, to smell stuff, to look at all the little tracks and signs, and to see a whole bunch of the smaller little mammals that you're never going to see in a game drive vehicle when you're driving, and the noise of the engine and that. So as we're going, I'll turn on and off and record a little bit. Hope you enjoy. There's a beautiful little leopard tortoise. He's a little bit smaller than a football, and he's feeding off the leaves of a tall white squirrel. As we're busy walking, and one of the things we're always going to be looking out for is wind direction. And I'm busy walking on a game trail now, and there's some nice soft sand around, so I'm just going to give it a kick quickly. And the wind is carrying straight down this game trail over here, which is fine. You can't always have everything 100% right. So what we'll do is we'll carry on walking, and when the opportunity presents itself, we'll either make a detour. Alternatively, if we see anything at long distance and we want to do an approach onto that animal, something like a rhino or an elephant or buffalo or something like that, then you know, an animal's sense of smell is phenomenal. It's great. We're going to have to then work with the wind to get that into our favor, so that we'll be able to get up to the animal, view it, and they won't be able to pick up on us. So here's a nice set of white rhino tracks that we can follow up on. If we look at the fingerprints inside the track, it's nice and sharp. There's good definition there. The wind hasn't had a chance to erode the spoor in any way. What I am seeing is a little bit of insect movement through the track, and there's an antlion larval pit that has had a chance to semi-rebuild his pit since the white rhino have walked over this area. But it is fresh enough for us to follow up on, so we'll give it a go. So there you can see a little antlion. That's the round back end of it, and then those vicious jaws at the front, and that allows them to latch hold of any little prey that happens to fall into their larval pits. They then grab hold of it, suck them dry, and then throw out the exoskeleton of that insect. So when we're looking at tracks and signs left behind by animals, often one of the signs that we look at is the dung left behind by animals. This is quite old zebra dung. You can see quite easily to tell zebra dung. They're these nice kidney shaped pieces of quite nicely chewed up grass, nice and fine on the inside there. Quite a decent sized pile of it, looks very much similar to horse dung. If we have a look on top over here, there's stuff that isn't zebra dung, and that is what we find typically from blackback jackals. Being territorial within this area, they'll be depositing their dung on top of something else, either on top of zebra dung, on top of a bush, on top of a rock, anything to get it higher, so that they can obviously have their marking higher, more prevalent, and they can communicate the message better. There are two white rhino busy sleeping. We have got a lot of general game in this area. Zebras, giraffe, there's some kudu, a whole bunch of springbok, and that can make approaching other animals a little bit tricky. If they get spooked, they can alert the white rhino to our presence. So we're going to have to do quite a careful approach. We're going to make sure the wind direction is right, and we're going to make sure that we move nice and slowly so we don't startle other animals. See white rhinos sleeping like this together. It's extra protection that when they are sleeping and fast asleep, that they sleep facing outwards, so that there's always a horn pointing outwards as an extra deterrent against would-be predators like lions. those guys have stood up, so I'm gonna leave them be. Beautiful green-eyed monster busy drinking the nectar from a candelabra flower. Well, I really enjoyed that, being out on foot today on a guided walk. I've decided to split the walk onto two separate videos just because there's so much that we saw that I can't keep it to 5 minutes. So if you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up, give it a like, stay safe, and we'll see you on the next video. Bye.